It took me 20 years to figure this out, but what we're going to talk about today is how to make sure your ground blind does not blow away. And I don't know about you, but I have retrieved torn up ground blinds, especially in the spring when we're turkey hunting, a dozen times. And it's because I didn't properly secure the blind. Now, I'll be setting a Rig'em Right blind today, and the string they provide and the stakes they provide is more than adequate. If you're going to set a blind, you're going to hunt it, leave it up for a couple days, take it down, or in most cases, you know, this blind set up specifically to do this is you pack it in, it's camouflage on the outside instead of black, you're slipping in, you're setting the blind, you're hunting, you're taking it down. That's more than adequate. But I'm going to set this blind. It's 2 weeks before turkey season here in Pike County, Illinois. So this blind is going to be up until the third week in May. So it's going to be up for a long time. It's going to see rain. It's going to see high winds. And in some cases, we even get snow. I killed one in the snow last year. So what I'm going to do is share with tips with you on how to make sure that your blind doesn't blow away. I set a few things out here. Number one, this is some 550 paracord, okay? You can get it in camouflage, you can get it black, it doesn't matter. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna leave the rope that is on the blind, I'm gonna leave it there, but I'm just not going to use it. I'm gonna go ahead and cut some of this paracord and I'm gonna use this to secure it to my stakes. Now I've set out a couple different stakes. Instead of using the provided smaller black stakes, I'm going to use these internally only. And what this allows is I can pound this stake in and this tab goes into the ground. So this is what I'm going to use on the inside. And on the outside, I'm going to use two different posts. I'm going to pound these posts on each side of the prevailing wind, which is north and south here. And then I'm going to use these, I'm going to use rebar here. And I'm gonna put that on my east-west side. And I'm gonna drive that rebar all the way in so that this hook goes into the ground, okay? And you can see, you know, that's gonna put it quite a ways into the ground. That's what's gonna give you that security. The other thing about rebar is it's got some texture to it, you know, so it's harder to pull out of the ground. Now, this is the Midwestern version of this video. When I set ground blinds, and I set a lot of them, at my Oklahoma ranch or my Kansas ranch, we use T-posts, okay? We're just driving the T-posts. But the most important thing at that point is you need to make sure you either use paracord or you're using some rope, because that's gonna be your weakest link at that point once you have those T-posts driven in the ground. So now this preseason, so it's not as important, but I carry this in my box here when I'm setting blinds, and it's a big rubber mallet. So when I go in, I'm not gonna wanna be banging with a metal hammer on these posts. So this is much quieter than banging away with a standard hammer. So that's just a little tip if you need to move that blind, you know, to keep that in your case. The other thing that I always keep with me is I have a handsaw, because you know, you never know where you're gonna set up. And sometimes I like to trim out so I can tuck that blind up against the tree. If I do that, then what I do is I eliminate one of these posts and I take the paracord and I wrap that around the tree, you know, so that totally ensures that the blind's not going to blow away. Now, it may not be standing when you get there, but at least it's going to be in that same spot and you can quickly and hopefully quietly put it back up. And then I'm going to show you one other piece, and you guys have all seen this, but this is a brace that goes to the ground and you push it up to the hub system and it just locks. What this does is in rain or snow, it gives that blind extra stability. And this is a brand new one that I found, and I've tried every single one of them. I have no idea what the name is. You'll just have to Google it, go on Amazon's where I bought it, and it just twists and it goes down. It's quiet. It doesn't have any, there's no clicks, snaps. And the old style right here at the hub used to have slots here so that it goes onto the hub system. And that logic is good as far as locking it in, but guess what also it is? Super noisy. Where this one, you just put it in, and you just twist it, it locks in. So look, there's nothing. So just make sure when you're putting this in, push up on the hub so that you've got maximum resistance, and that cup will sit around it and it's nice and quiet. So then when you get in there to hunt, you just slip it down, and what I just set it right down on the ground. So if you set up a ground blind using these techniques, I cannot guarantee that it's not going to blow away, because let's face it, sometimes houses blow away, right? I mean, there are going to be conditions that are stronger than what I'm doing here. But since I've started doing this, I've never had a blind blow away. And there's quite honestly very few things that are more frustrating and certainly inconvenient when you're slipping in the morning to hunt that big gobbler and you get to where your blind is and it's gone. This is the internal stake that comes with the Rig'em Right blind. It's very similar to any other brand out there. This is the external stake. Like I already mentioned, both of these are more than sufficient for normal use. What we're talking about is heavy duty or extreme use. So you can, let's just compare. This is, I'm replacing the internal stake with a tent stake. This piece is going to run perpendicular to the ground on the inside of the blind. This piece, this tent stake, is going to go into the ground, okay? It's larger in diameter and it's longer. So it just stands to reason it's gonna hold much better. Now let's compare the external stake to what we're using here. So larger diameter and, you know, three times the depth. The other thing, when we're driving these, we're not gonna put them at straight. We're gonna drive them in at an angle until this piece goes all the way into the ground. So we got the blind set up. The first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna stake the inside. And that's really important first step, because we wanna make sure the blind can't move, because when we attach the paracord, we're gonna pull hard on that, and we're gonna pull against those hubs. So if you do that before you stake it on the inside, the blind's gonna move around. So we wanna get the blind, and when we put the internal stakes, we're gonna push out. Okay, so we're gonna push out, push out, push out. And then once we get those set, we're gonna pull hard, okay? Okay, so this, again, I got it on Amazon, 550 paracord. It's camouflage, and what 550 stands for, it's rated up to 550 pounds. But I did notice something here that it mentions that I just wanna make sure everybody aware of. This is not for parachuting, okay? I guess some people saw it was worth paracord, called paracord, so they thought it was for parachuting, but it's not. But it's gonna work great for what we're doing. So we're gonna cut our paracord here. It's important to remember that the tab on this blind, or any blind, this is for popping the hub, not for tying the string to. We wanna go right here. We wanna go to the actual metal part of the hub, okay? So that's what we're gonna tie to. It's been a long time since I was in Boy Scouts, so I don't have a fancy knot for you, so I'm just gonna tie a bunch of them. That's my best advice there. We just tied a bunch of knots. We're gonna pull it tight. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna pull on that cord. So I'm gonna set that stake in a spot to where I've really gotta pull on it to tie it to. We're gonna put the stake at an angle. We're gonna use this rubber mallet that's much quieter. So just remember, we're gonna pull against this hub. So we're just gonna pull it, wrap it around so it's tight. You wanna make sure that you've got some good force against that. And then we're gonna tie it. When we first started talking about this, I said I just leave this cord on, the one that came with the blind. And again, now what you can do if you want is you can double stake this, okay? It just depends on how extreme you want to go. If you got the time, it's not going to hurt. You have the stakes that came with the blind. You can add that on. We're not going to here, but, you know, that is, If you're worried about it, that is an additional piece that you can do. So same thing, we're gonna pull on it. The only difference is we're using a rebar piece here. Again, four of these rebars is gonna work perfect. If you don't have that, a T-post, anything, you know, metal, long, something you can get deep in the ground at an angle. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tie on underneath, and then I'm gonna drive, once I've got it tight, I'm gonna drive it the rest of the way into the ground. So I just pulled tight there against that back hub. Three or four knots. One of the things you can do if you want to use your paracord over and over again is you can take a lighter and burn the ends. I've just found that I'm going to put new cord on. So we've got that knot underneath. Now we're going to take the tip of this rebar with it and we're going to drive it all the way into the ground. That's what you want to be able to play a song on it. A little Jason Aldean. Welcome to my crib. Come on in. So then this is your center post. There's a variety of them out there. I just found this one. I like it because it's quick and easy and quiet. What you're going to do is you're just going to take this. You're going to push up on the blind a little bit. And then you're going to tighten it. So no matter which one you use, it just goes right on the hub. You're gonna push up that way if it rains, snows. Then when you come to hunt, you just push up a little bit. This one you can just take down, throw it in the back of the blind. Again, this isn't something you need to do if it's just a temporary set. If it's gonna be here for a day or two, you know, or you're just going in to hunt. These are extra things that we do. It's a lot more work, but it's totally worth it. So it took me 20 years and chasing a dozen blinds out of the shrubs before I developed this system. It's nothing that is super scientific, but I promise you, this blind is going to be here when I come to hunt. Last tip. What we're gonna do is we're gonna leave a few of these windows open. We're gonna put up the screens, but we're gonna leave them open. We're not gonna zip the door. Our prevailing wind north, south, so we're gonna make sure we've got wind that can flow through here, okay? Make it less of a sail and let the wind come through. Not to mention when you slip in here in the morning, it's much quieter than zipping and unzipping. So meet me out front. I'm gonna show you the last thing and we'll wrap up. But this is the way we want it. If you don't see your blind slightly distorted, you don't have it tight enough, okay? So that is the way, if you're looking, man, is this good, that's what you wanna see. So we've staked the four corners, we put the tent stakes on the inside, we put the post in the middle, we're gonna leave the windows open. And if you do these things, I think you'll be pleasantly surprised that after that thunderstorm rolls through, and those gobblers are fired up, that when you slip in there, your blind's there.